My name is Nick Santangelo. I am the graduate director of the Integrative Biology Program at Hofstra University for Masters of Science and Masters of Art. Our master's program offers a variety of fields of training. So our title is integrative because we have many different faculty in a variety of different areas. So depending on what you are interested in, you can probably find something that is suitable for you. What we do is we try to train students given what their interests are and what trajectory they have, and so each of the mentors that we have in the program are familiar with their fields of area of expertise. So we try to gear the training for the students for what they want to get into. Outside of the lab, we also have faculty that are professionals in conservation and ecology work. So we have a lot of ongoing projects. The unique thing about our program for graduate students is that the mentoring that you get is very specific to what the students want to do. So when a student comes in and decides they want a particular trajectory, whether it's working in a medical field or working in conservation or going on to do a PhD, the training you get is very different for those types of trajectories. So what you get is very individualized. It's not a standard thing across the department because every student is individual. So you work very closely with your mentor, and as long as there's open communication about what it is you want to do, your training will be geared towards that. Training in the pre-medical or the medical professional, we have students that are looking at antimicrobial processes with some of our microbiologists. We have conservation in terms of genetics and doing genetic profiling of various species that are either of some type of concern. We also have students that are doing projects in terms of species that are coming in that might be invasive species. The students that are the most successful in our program are the ones that have a real work ethic. What really determines success in graduate work, which is very different than undergraduate work, is your dedication to the project that you choose. The project that students choose is very individualized, so it needs to be something that they're interested in. So of course they work with a faculty member that's familiar with the project and the questions that they're asking. But a lot of the work is very individualized, and there's not necessarily a set endpoint. So it's very easy typically for students to say, okay, I'll do X, Y, and Z when I get to it. So time management and being dedicated to your question. Of course, if there's an interest in your question, then you're going to be much more driven to do it. And so the students that I've seen that are the most successful are really interested in their question and really take ownership of their project. Because we have a lot of labs that are common use space. So not only are the students training on various instruments that they can use across different labs, but there's also a lot of integration and collaboration across students. So we have labs that have a lot of various molecular equipment, PCRs and cell culturing equipment. And outside of that, in terms of for conservation, we have a soils lab that we actually share with geology and sustainability. So we actually integrate with other programs across campus as well, not just within the department. Outside of campus, we also integrate a lot with the community. So we have students that work, that utilize a lot of citizen movements. So for example, every summer there are horseshoe crab counts that they do, where there's a local agency will utilize citizens to monitor the spawning of these horseshoe crabs. We've actually utilized those citizens to collect data for us, and I've had graduate students that have actually utilized that data, so working with the citizens, and they get a real thrill out of being a part of some research that's actually going on at a university that ends up getting published in national journals.